He was saying to himself in memory. Let's go to memory and hear what he said to himself. His situation got worse. As soon get out of your way, the Bible says, in memory, he said to himself, this is not who I am. Yeah. In memory, there was the rich man's son. He said, this is not who I am. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Number two, he said, if the servant have so much bread, that means my father is a rich man.
Yes, he is. Mm-hmm.
And my father cannot be a rich man and I'll be eating with pigs. That picture is awkward. Uh-huh. And if the least servant got so much bread, I got no need to be hungry.
Amen.
So, when his memories keep, he taught him three major things from his memory book. And then his imagination stepped right in. After he said, my father had more than enough. He said in verse 18, this is what I will do. God will not do something unless you do something.
Amen. Amen.
God is waiting for you to do something first.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
If you don't do something, God will not do something. Yes. He says, this is what I will do. Paul said, this thing I do, forgetting that which is behind, and pressing forth to the mark of the high calling. This man said, this is what I will do. I will go back to my father.
Yes. Yes.
The Bible says, he arose. He didn't sit there and thought. He arose. I will go back to my father. I will go back. Not only just going back, I'll be specific where I'm going to.
Amen.
I'm going to my father.
Yes.
And this is why he said, I will say, the man was in the forest, and he said, I'll say, Father, I've sinned in heaven and against you. I'm no longer worthy to be called your son. You know what he was saying? When I go back to my father, I will submit to my father.
Amen. 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 Amen.
I will show you in scripture what took him off was not submission. He said, I will go back to my father and I will submit to my father. Why? Humility will make you realize you're wrong. And will break the pride in.
Yes.
This man was proud to the point he was sleeping with pig. Until he started eating with pig. Then he knew he was down to the lowest. And God was only using that as a means of breaking the pride in him. That's why he said, I know what I will do. I'll go back to my father. And I will say, Father, I've sinned against you. I'm not worthy to be called yourself, to be called your son. How can a son bring himself down?
Mm-hmm.
Unless he's broken.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
God cannot use any vessel unless that vessel is broken. He said, this is what I will say to my father. When he came to himself, after he came to himself, he did not go to the town to join a self-help group.
No.
He didn't seek to repair his inner child. Oh, you know, that's not the way I came out. You know, the situation. No, he did not. He didn't blame his friends. Sometimes we are responsible for our own issues, and instead of taking responsibility, we tend to blame our friends. We tend to blame people for our situation. He didn't blame his friends for his condition. Oh, you are promoting, and the area, yeah, me, yeah, poor me, in the big bed. No! He He didn't believe his boss, who gave him a job to feed the pigs and to keep living. He didn't bring the pigs out of the big day he grew by sharing the food and a shelter with him. Stop bleeding people and take responsibility for your actions.
Amen. 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 Amen.
He said, I will rise and go back to my father. That where I blunder, I must go back to where I blunder and make it right. Sometimes we make mistake here and we don't correct the mistake. We go to another place, we make another mistake, and we go to another place and we make another mistake, and that starts to fall apart, and we start to bleed somebody from the village, some our cousin, some our auntie, some our uncle, some our nephew, not realizing that the mistake was made from the beginning and was never corrected.
Yes.
He said, I will go back to my father. Go to my father. He said, I'll go back to my father. And the Bible says the man's focus was on going back to his father. That was a focus. He was not thinking about prayer. He said, I'll go back to my father. And he purposed what he would say. And he arose and started going back. Now, some Bible scholar believed that when the man said in a pig pen, my father's servant got more here, and I realized my wrong, I would tell my father that I've sinned against heaven, against him. It was not repentance. He was not repenting. He was just saying what had been spoken to his spirit that he would do. Because the option to walk from where he went to his father's house and repeat what he said was purposefully left for him. He would have changed his story on his way back to his father.
Yeah.
Because his father had no idea what he intended to say. And the Bible says he started going back. Now, if you read the story, I will soon be out of your way. I'll soon be out of your way. When he started going back, why he was a great way off. Why he was a great way off. In other words, the father made it his duty to walk from his house all the way to the end of the village. Every day, waiting to see his son.
Amen.
The father was not in the house, or else he would not have seen his son. He was not in the yard, else he would not have seen his son. He saw his son from a distance. And this is what he did, because the father was well dressed. And they dressed in robe according to the tradition. When properties are divided, it's either doing death. It's rare in the Jewish custom that properties are divided when the heir is living. But he had to do that. So he was a disgrace to the family. And he decided to come. The father was standing at the edge. He was standing coming outside his compound, and he saw his son afar off. And the Bible says, I believe the father took his garments, rolled it up in his hands, instead of the son running to the father. It was the father running to the son. Read the scripture. The Bible says he ran to his son. And when he ran to his son, the word of God says, he laid his head on his son's shoulder. Why did he run to his son? Because it's a disgrace for your son to live like that and return to the village. So the father chose to run to the son and meet the son outside of the village to take his shame and disgrace before he entered the village. When he ran outside and met the son was not clean. Bible met the son was not clean. He fell on his neck and started showering him with kisses. Mm-hmm. How can this man who clean meet a son who lived with pigs and ate pig food and hug that son and shower him with kisses? Did he do that? Started kissing him. Why did he have to go through the period of kissing his son all over? Bible said he showered him with kisses. The father had to do an action. When the father saw him, the father saw a different person. Amen. Remember, the boy had just come. He had not even spoken to the father what he said he would say. He just came and the father ran to him and started showering with kisses all over. The father, the Bible says, the father pitied his son. When he saw him, he pitied him. Because his condition was horrible, but yet he chose to kiss him. Why? I don't care how terrible your son looks. I don't care how terrible your child looks. Your child is your child. I don't care how much nasty or dirty or how many poop that child has on them. You won't mind taking the trash. You won't mind taking the poop. You won't mind taking the shame because that's your child. And the man ran off the village and said, let me make you a different person here. Now listen to the word of God. He buried him. He didn't stop there. Because he left the way he left. The Bible says, he turned to those who went with him. And when he was showering him with kisses, then the son started explaining, a broken son, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I'm not qualified to be called your son. The father was not concerned about that. He turned to his servants and said to his servant, bring the best robe. Put it on him right here. Bring the best robe. I mean, the father sent for the robe from his house to clothe his son at the tip of the village. Bring the best robe. Put it on him. The ring, put it on his finger. And the sandals on his feet. You know what the father did at the end of the village? The robe meant when he went out, he went up as a royal son. He came back. He came back empty and naked. And the father could not afford for a royal son to enter the village unclothed. He said, take the best robe. That is royalty. Put on him a robe of royalty. The second thing he said, take the ring. The ring is a signal ring. The ring signifies authority. Take the ring and put it on his finger. And lastly, he said, when the boy was still talking, he said, yo, bring the sandals. Take the sandals and put it on his feet. Why? In the Jewish custom, slaves don't put on shoes. So he came without shoes because he had declared himself a slave. If the father was able to change a rule, and the father was able to give him a ring of authority, it was the father's will to give him the sandals to tell him, you, even though you declare yourself slave, you are no longer slave, you are the son. At the tip of the village, and he said, bring. This ceremony taking place right at the tip of the village. Bring the fat calf, kill it, and let us celebrate. Because this, my son, was dead, is alive. Was lost, is found. Now let me ask you, most of the time we start the story right there, but that's not the end of the story. The next 2 minutes will be ending the story. What do you mean by that, Bishop? There were three persons in the story. The father and two sons. We just spoke about the father and the son that left. But the Bible says while the party was going on, while the celebration was going on, while everybody was enjoying themselves, the older son heard the music. As he drew closer to the house, he heard the dancing and the music. And so he called one of the servants and said, what's going on out there? What's going on in the house? And the servant said to him, your brother has come back. And your father is having a party. The Bible says, he was angry and could not go in. Therefore, his father came out and pleaded with him. And said to him, your brother, listen to the father's word. Many years I have served you the son accusation. You have never had a party. I never gone wrong. You never gave me a boat for me and my friend to celebrate. I think this son forgot. From the beginning of the scripture, the Bible says the father divided the goods among them. So in other words, every brother had a share. He chose to not leave, but he had his share. But his accusation was he wanted a party. Now, that was what he said. You never gave me a good. So, listen to what he said. But as soon as this son of yours, in other words, he was so angry that he refused to call in his brother. Oh, read scripture. I'm not saying something different. He disowned his little brother because of party. But as soon as this son of yours, you celebrating. And not only that, the man was living with prostitutes. Listen to it. I don't know you're reading it here. The man was living with prostitutes. The man lived with prostitutes throughout. Yet you chose to have party for that son of yours. And he said to his son, you always here. All I have is yours. This son was lost and now it's home. But there is no scripture to show that he ever went into the party. I don't think he did. Maybe that's why the young son left in the first place. Because he went to the father. So maybe he had problem with the older brother. Because from the response of the older brother, he tells you that he just didn't love the younger son coming back. And all this festivity. Look how he responds instead of being rejoicing. And so he refused to go to the party. the younger brother as a close. The younger brother, the younger son went to a far away country. But his heart was with his father.
Amen.
The older brother was with his father, but his heart was far away. He didn't realize that you are not beyond redemption. He didn't realize that it's never too late to begin again. He did not realize that. He refused to celebrate because he felt he was not treated right. Which one are you? The oldest? I would say, I've been here a long time and God has not blessed me. And somebody taking over there and being blessed. Or the youngest? Who lavished everything they had, yet the father were willing to stretch his hand. Jesus paid the price no matter where we are.
Amen.
And he's willing for us to come. Just as we are.
Amen.
To lavish us with kisses. And to tell us you can begin again. Nothing is beyond my redemption. Can we stay?